Welcome everyone. In this video, I'm going to give a detailed overview about everything you need to know related to Amazon Security Lake pricing. Let's get started with what is Security Lake for those not familiar. Amazon Security Lake automatically centralizes security data from AWS environments, SaaS providers, on-premises, and cloud sources into a purpose-built data lake that is stored within a customer's AWS accounts. If security teams need to perform logging, Security Lake is the place to do it. You might be thinking, what's the difference between my existing logging options? Amazon Security Lake is purpose-built to gain visibility into your security data. It normalizes to a consistent schema, OCSF, and manages several infrastructure components to make analyzing this data cost-efficient. The data is compressed in Apache Parquet format, which makes your overall data footprint in S3 over 90% smaller over traditional JSON objects across AWS source types. Security Lake also partitions by things like region, account ID, and event day, and lifecycle policies are easily managed in S3 to achieve the optimal storage tier for this data. If new accounts are added or removed from an organization, Security Lake manages the Amazon S3 partitions to accommodate your ever-changing account structure. This enables security teams to focus more on threat hunting, investigations, or visualizing data rather than data management. Now let's go deeper into Security Lake pricing. So how does Security Lake charge? Security Lake is a volume-based billing model for AWS logs only. It is priced along two dimensions, volume of AWS logs ingested and normalization of AWS logs into OCSF. The price for CloudTrail is 75 cents per gig and 25 cents per gig for all other log sources such as Amazon EKS audit logs and VPC flow logs. For custom logs, Amazon Security Lake doesn't charge anything. You simply pay for the underlying S3 cost for storing these logs. Now that you're orchestrating log collection in Security Lake and storing in Amazon S3, you can realize savings for log storage in two different ways. One, if you have multiple different data streams of AWS log sources, you can reduce those down to one and take advantage of Security Lake subscribers to let others consume these logs from across your organization. And now that you're storing logs long-term in Security Lake and S3, you only need to send logs to your analytics solution specific to your analytics needs, and not just as a place to store them long-term, and only need to store them for that solution for the amount of time you need to analyze them. After that time frame, you'll still have access to use different tools to query in place in Security Lake using tools such as Athena, if you ever need to access them again. Keep in mind, Security Lake has a 15-day free trial to help customers evaluate the service and the cost of the service when getting started. Often, I'm asked what other types of services does Security Lake orchestrate for me and how much will these cost? So, as we mentioned in our last example, Security Lake uses S3 to store data and also uses other services including AWS Lambda, Amazon EventBridge, Amazon SQS, and AWS Glue Data Catalog for orchestration. To estimate costs for these services, expect that the cost will be roughly 3% of overall Security Lake costs. So if your Security Lake monthly bill is $100, the cost of the orchestration services will be roughly 3%. So your total cost of Security Lake will be $103. Keep in mind, your Security Lake bill will show $100 and you'll have the $3 spread across respective orchestration services. So next, let's jump in the Security Lake console and look at the usage tab. Now that we are looking at the usage page in the Amazon Security Lake console for an AWS organization that has a total of 9 accounts, this brings up another question that is asked frequently, which is, does the delegated admin account in your AWS organization incur all the costs for Security Lake? Keep in mind that although we are viewing all costs in this delegated admin account, the delegated admin account in which Security Lake runs is not billed for all accounts. This account only incurs the charges for log collection for this account, plus any charges related to the data lake components that are orchestrated by Security Lake in this account, such as S3, Lambda, SQS, Glue, or EventBridge. On the usage page, we can see what our total projected cost for all the accounts for the month, and we have a table that shows us the breakdown of cost per data source. If you look at the columns, you can see actual usage for one day, total predicted usage per month, and total predicted cost per month. We can change the actual usage timeline at the top In this example, we'll just change it to 7 days. And as you can see, we have our exact usage numbers for the last 7 days. We can also look at this by account. This gives us the visibility into what accounts are collecting different amounts of data. Finally, this brings us to our last point. Most customers want to know how they can estimate Secure Lake pricing. There are two different ways to do this. The best way is to turn on the free trial and look at the usage page in the Security Lake console to get an accurate count of usage in your environment. Each environment is different and each application creates different amounts of log volumes, so getting this actual usage is the best way to estimate. If you currently understand the amount of logs you'll be collecting, you can use the AWS pricing calculator to estimate Security Lake pricing. As you will see, this will roughly align to 1.5% of overall AWS. In this video, we went over how is Amazon Security Lake charged and how are some ways that you can estimate Security Lake and look at your Security Lake usage. If you have any more Security Lake pricing questions, please go to the Amazon Security Lake pricing link in the description below.